It looked like he was trying to turn back towards the east. And when he did, it either his wing hit the water or he just lost his lift. And down he went.
Two people are injured when their experimental aircraft goes down in a North Texas lake. Three people die in a devastating collision when a truck is crushed between two 18-wheelers. See why some commuters are calling for immediate changes on many stretches of that highway. Those stories and more right ahead here on Texas Cable News.
The state of Texas 24/7. This is TXCN, Texas Cable News.
Thanks for joining us here at Texas Cable News. I'm Dan Ronan. More on those stories in just a moment. But first, Bob Goosmann is in the Texas Weather Center. Good evening, Bob.
Hey, Dan, we've got these thunderstorms in the southeast part of the state starting to get a little stronger, although they're not going to have much more life once that sun sets. Right now, there is a cool front, yes, cool front, mid-July, cutting the state in half, and the temperatures are beginning to reflect a little bit of cooler air up to the north, 89, DFW 81. Not that bad at all up in Amarillo. Still nice and sultry south of that front, though, very high humidities. Here is the radar loop over the last, let's say, 45 minutes or so. The latest storms have developed right over the Lufkin area, heading to the southeast. Those will probably last for at least another hour to hour and a half. Then when we lose the daytime heating, we'll lose those storms. And the storms up in the panhandle will probably last for the next couple of hours, passing to the south of Amarillo. Then things will quiet down later on, and then more storms will probably ignite in south and west Texas during the day tomorrow. 70s for the most part overnight tonight in north Texas, warming to the mid-90s tomorrow. A real humid night overnight tonight in the south. Temperatures above 100 on the Rio Grande, 102 Laredo, West Texas, 60s, lower 70s tonight, then warming to the mainly upper 80s and lower 90s, but 101 out in El Paso. We'll have your five-day forecast coming up in just a few minutes, Dan.